Well, hello. Welcome to this week's Dividend Cafe. So much to cover. It just feels like a whirlwind of a week. And yet, actually, it's been a very non-dramatic week in the markets. Hasn't been at this time, anyways. We're getting close to late in the week here. Big old spikes and volatility and movements around risk assets, equity markets, interest rates, etc. But it sure feels like a big dramatic week, and that's largely because of the political spectrum. And so if you were sleeping under a rock in the middle of the ocean in a different continent in outer space this week, you may not have known that President Trump's campaign manager for a while, Paul Manafort, was convicted on 8 felony charges. There was a hung jury on 10 of them. And then President Trump's former personal attorney pled guilty to a number of felony charges and has agreed to cooperate with prosecutors and so forth on some other things. So you have this seemingly momentous event in the political side. The cable news channels all run with it with different angles and perspectives and things. But markets just shrugged it off completely. Couldn't care less. And I think that's probably where I'll spend most of my time right now talking about it. I unpack it a little bit more at dividendcafe.com. And of course, I address other topics that aren't as core to this week's kind of conversation about municipal bonds, about the U.S. dollar, about the importance of a plan over against a portfolio itself, how the portfolio needs to work in concert with a plan. So all kinds of good stuff that we normally would cover in our weekly Dividend Cafe. But just from the politics and money side of things, people continue, and I guess sometimes, to be honest, I continue to be a little bit amazed at the ability of markets to shrug off some of the drama out of the White House, particularly obviously since the election of 2016, the campaign of 2015. You know, we're now a few years into this. This was pretty big news week in the political side, but the markets didn't care because the markets don't have anything to care about with it. I think you could get to a point in theory. I think everybody could envision some scenario in which it gets even more unpredictable, more uncertain, and more, you know, problematic. And that even then, I don't think it would create any repricing. I think it would just elevate volatility, understandably, around elevated uncertainty. But for the most part, the markets are focused on what markets are focused on. I think the central bank and the Fed have a lot to do with that, the state of interest rates. Earnings season was extremely strong, and that's more or less wrapped up. And so the whole story about trade tariff versus earnings is still markets focus. And it's been a pretty, you know, benign environment for equities the last month and a half. And the fact of the matter is that the Mueller probe and all that's been going on for about a year and a half now, not quite a year and a half. And, I think most people are, it's almost sport for a lot of people, but the market doesn't do sport. The market does pricing and discounting of risk and reward, cash flows, earnings, profits, and disappointments in expectation. That's what markets do. So that's the reason. You go back to everything that was happening in 2017, first year the president was elected, and they said, tweeting things, or oh, what about North Korea? What about Russia? What about this and that? Market never responded. So the markets have certain things acting, particularly in U.S. markets, much less so in a lot of international markets, that they feel at peace with, okay? So that's the reason the markets don't respond. I do believe that the situation of the Federal Reserve, they're in Jackson Hole, Wyoming, this week for their annual symposium, and we will see. The Fed is going to raise rates in September, at least 94% chance they will, according to the futures market. And there's a 60% chance in the futures market that they'll raise again in December. And that maybe, so 60% is not 90, 95, 100. Maybe they won't. But more or less, we know the Fed's trying to tighten. And we know that earnings are through the roof. The economy's growing rapidly. And those things just are more important to the market. So I will tell you that we're not surprised that the market has not been disrupted this week. I don't think you should be either. And I think everything I just said is from a purely market investment-oriented standpoint, not personally, politically, or even just kind of culturally. I mean, this is more of a society-wide story than anything else. So read dividendcafe.com. get a chance to look at the impact of tax reform versus trade war and tariffs. Look at the state of corporate debt in America. We have charts on these things. That's why I point you to the website. And then listen to the Advice and Insights podcast for a little deeper dive around the Federal Reserve. It's very quick, but we want to just cover some things that need to be said about the Fed. And in the meantime, have a wonderful weekend. We'll come back to you next week. Thanks for watching our Dividend Cafe video.